Welcome to Headline News 24/7. Please click like and subscribe. Trump's going down, Rosie says during Cohen hearing, gets destroyed. Rosie O'Donnell started to celebrate as the president's former disgraced attorney, Micheal Cohen, began his testimony before the House Committee on Oversight and Government Reform today. Trump's going down. Oh, happy day! Exclaimed the 56-year-old Trump hater. Then, things went all wrong. Immediately, Rosie's celebration turned into ashes, and she got utterly destroyed. You'll love this. The Democrats made good on the midterm promise that if they won the majority in the House of Representatives, they would plunge this nation into multiple investigations into President Trump. In fact, the Democrats leading the House Committee on Oversight called a convicted liar and felon, Micheal Cohen, to testify against Trump on their very first hearing. These Democratic snakes also scheduled this hearing as the president is meeting with North Korean dictator Kim Jong-un, and that says it all. They could care less about securing peace with the man Barack Obama claimed was the biggest national security concern for America. Which brings us to Rosie O'Donnell and her off-the-hook response to the Cohen hearing. Hollywood exploded with unhinged hot takes Wednesday as President Donald Trump's former personal attorney Micheal Cohen spoke at a congressional hearing about his work for Trump, Breitbart reported. At the beginning of the hearing, the hefty comedian tweeted, "Oh, the GOP is pissed and we haven't even started. This is gonna be good, Trump is going down, oh happy day." But that's not all. Rosie was just getting started, and it doesn't end well for the Trump hater. During the hearing, Micheal Cohen produced copies of checks from the president to him, purported to be reimbursement for hush money payment to Stormy Daniels. Cohen also admitted that he has no actual evidence of the 2016 campaign colluding with Russia, but that he has suspicions about it, Breitbart added. Yet, Cohen also testified under oath that the president got a call from Roger Stone in July 2016. Cohen stated Stone told Trump he spoke to Julian Assange, who said the WikiLeaks email dump on Hillary Clinton would be happening soon. Well, Cohen was caught in a lie. Trump could not have known in advance about WikiLeaks because Stone did not actually know himself in advance, as Mueller made clear in his indictment documenting Stone's texts and emails at the time. Then, Cohen testified he never wanted a job at the White House after Trump won. Again, another lie. Representative Jim Jordan pointed out, according to the Southern District of New York, Cohen privately told friends and colleagues, including in seized text messages, that he expected to be given a prominent role in the new Trump administration. When that did not materialize, Cohen found a way to monetize his relationship and access with the president. Eric Trump tweeted, "Michael was lobbying everyone to be chief of staff. It was the biggest joke in the campaign and around the office. Did he just perjure himself again?" Yep, he did. Hearing Cohen caught in lie after lie, Rosie gets upset. That's when her artwork becomes really unhinged and all she can say is, "Con man, fraud, liar, bum, hashtag impeach Trump now." The hefty celebrity's happiness at the beginning of Cohen's hearing is gone. She has now gone over to the dark side. Then, things get really crazy. Micheal Cohen gets grilled by Representative Jim Jordan and Representative Mark Meadows, who caused the disbarred attorney to admit he consulted with Democrat Investigative Committee leaders Cummings and Schiff before preparing his testimony, along with Clinton fixer attorney Lanny Davis, who strangely is working pro bono for Cohen. "I spoke to Mr. Schiff about topics that were going to be raised at the upcoming hearing," Cohen told Representative Jim Jordan when pressed about the pair's past discussion. "Whoa," Jordan responded. "Not just what time you're going to show up, but what you're going to talk about. Whoa." Yep, Cohen testifies he is colluding with the Democratic leaders who holding these so-called hearings. And of course, his lawyer Lanny Davis, the notorious Clinton fixer, is working for free, just out of the kindness of his heart. Poor Rosie didn't respond well to this part of the hearing. It looked like she had given up hope that these snakes would nail Trump. O'Donnell has no words. Instead, she tweets a really disturbing picture she drew of Donald Trump with the word treason posted in large print across it. Rosie had such high hopes. She thought after waiting for 2 years this Micheal Cohen hearing would destroy President Trump. She starts off tweeting, "Oh happy day." And then as Cohen tells lie after lie, the hefty actress realizes it's not like anything she imagined it would be, and her hopes got destroyed.
That was the news. We thought you might be interested in knowing about this. Please click like and subscribe. Thank you.